Welcome to another free Active Directory training video from ITFreeTraining. In this free video, just one video of the completely free Active Directory course, I will look at seizing operational master roles. Transferring the role is the safest way to move the operation master role. However, if your server becomes permanently offline for any reason, this will not be possible. When this occurs, you need to seize the role to make it available on another domain controller. Before making the decision to seize an operation master role, you should understand the impact not having that operation master role will have. If there is no impact on your organization, it may be worth your time trying to recover the failed domain controller so you can transfer the role to another domain controller safely. Let's review the five operation master roles and the impact not having these roles will have on your organization. First, you have the Schema Master. If you are not planning on making any changes to the schema, this role can be offline indefinitely. The next operational master role, Domain Name Master, is only required if adding or removing domains. If you are not adding or removing domains, this operational master role can be offline indefinitely. The RID Master can be down for a period of time and should not be missed. If you are not creating lots of objects in Active Directory, it could be down for an extended period without impacting the operation of your organization. Out of all the operational master roles, the PDC emulator is the most likely to cause an impact on your organization. Microsoft recommends that this role be available 24/7. The PDC emulator is considered the final say on authentication. Having this operational master role not available may mean that an end user may have trouble logging in after a password change. The PDC emulator is also the root of the time sync hierarchy in the domain. While the operational master role is down, time sync services will not occur to the other domain controllers. During this time, it is possible for the times on your domain controllers to drift, and this drift passed on to the clients. Lastly, you have the Infrastructure Master. In a single domain environment, this Operation Master role will not be missed during an extended outage. In a multi-domain environment, a missing Infrastructure Master can have an effect on group membership changes across domains. Once you understand the impact the missing Operational Master role will have on your organization, you can decide how much time you should wait before seizing the role. Before seizing the role, you should make sure the domain controller is offline. Seizing a role should not be performed if you have a network outage and your network is divided in half. Seizing an operational master role is considered a last resort when the domain controller is offline and will not be brought back online ever again. Once you make the decision to seize the operational master role, you need to understand that the domain controller cannot be used on the network again. Seizing a role is a drastic step and should not be taken lightly. If you later recover the domain controller that was holding an operation master role that was seized, you will need to reinstall the domain controller. On a large network with multiple domain controllers, you may have another domain controller allocated to transfer operation master roles to when needed. This is referred to as a standby operation master. A standby can be used when the operational master role needs to be seized or simply just transferred. Once you have seized the operational master role from the failed domain controller, the configuration for that domain controller will still exist in the Active Directory database. Since the domain controller will not be used on the network again, to complete the process, you should also remove the configuration information of the domain controller from Active Directory. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 domain controller to demonstrate how to seize an operation master role from a domain controller and also how to clean up the Active Directory database after the operation master role has been seized. If you have watched our previous video on transferring operation master roles, you will remember my opening Active Directory users and computers from the Start menu and selecting the option Operations Masters. This will allow you to transfer the domain operation master roles. notice that the RIDMaster has come up as error. The domain controller that is holding this operational master role is not available, and thus this will be displayed as an error. This tool and the other Active Directory GUI-based tools will only allow you to transfer roles. In order to seize a role, I need to use a command line tool. To do this, open a command line prompt and run the program ntdsutil. ntdsutil is the Active Directory diagnostic tool. The file name may seem a little strange, but if you remember that originally Active Directory was called NT Directory Services, the name of the file makes sense. When you launch ntdsutil, you will get an ntdsutil prompt. The ntdsutil has a lot of subcomponents which will allow you to run different functions and configure different settings. You can always tell which part you are in by looking at the prompt. For example, in this case, I want to seize an operation master role. To do this, I will enter in roles and press enter. Notice that the prompt has changed to FISMO maintenance to let me know I am now in a different part of the utility. Before I can make changes to any of the operation master roles, I need to enter in the command connections. In order for the FISMO maintenance to run any functions, it needs to be connected to a domain controller. The command prompt has now changed to server connections. Think of server connections as a submenu of FISMO maintenance. The next command that I will run is connect to server DC1. This will establish a connection back to one of my domain controllers. Now that I have a connection to a domain controller, I can enter in quit to return back to the FISMO maintenance section. If I enter in question mark, I can get a list of all the commands that can be run from FISMO maintenance. Notice that you could also transfer roles from here as well. This is a handy thing to know if you ever need to transfer an operation master role using server core. To seize the RID master role, enter in seize RID master role. Before continuing, Windows will first confirm that you want to seize the role. Once I confirm that this is what I want to do, notice that Windows will attempt to transfer the operational master role first before seizing it. Remember that seizing an operational master role should be taken very seriously. Once the operational master role has been seized, the domain controller holding that role cannot be brought back online again. If possible, always transfer the role rather than seizing it. It does take a minute or so for Windows to attempt to transfer the role and fail. I will fast forward the video to where the role gets seized. Here you will notice the RIDMaster is now on Domain Controller 1, or DC1. The format shown here is in LDAP format, which is not the easiest to read. If I exit out to the command prompt, I can run the netdom query FISMO. This will show you which domain controllers have the 5 operation master roles. Here you can once again see that DC1 holds the RID operational master role. The role has been seized by DC1, but configuration information about DC3 still remains in the Active Directory database. DC3 was the domain controller that held the RID operational master role before I seized the role. It is best to remove DC3 information data from Active Directory. To do this, once again, run ntdsutil. To remove DC3, I need to enter in metadata cleanup. From inside metadata cleanup, once again, I need to connect to a domain controller. I can do this the same way as before by running connections and then enter in connect to server DC1. Once connected to DC1, I will enter in quit to return back to metadata cleanup. Metadata cleanup will essentially remove the records for DC3 from Active Directory. To do this, I must first select DC3. This can be done by running select operation target. There are a number of settings that need to be set so the correct records can be selected and removed. First, I need to select the domain. To find out which domains are available, run the command list domains. There is only one domain, so I can select this with the command select domain 0. If you had more than one domain, you would need to run list domains to find out the number for the domain. If you only have one domain, you can simply just run select domain 0, knowing the correct and only domain will be selected. Next, I need to select the site that DC3 was assigned to. I have not covered sites yet. This will be covered in a later video. For the present, know that sites allow you to model Active Directory around your physical network infrastructure. If you have two locations separated by a wide area network, you would create two sites. So far, there are no additional sites that have been configured, so when I run list sites, I will only see the default site that Windows created when I installed Active Directory. To select the site, run the command select site and the number of the site, which in this case is 0. Lastly, I need to select the server that I want to remove. To do this, run the command list servers in site. DC3 is listed as server number 2, so I can select it with the command select server 2. Now that DC3 is selected, I can enter in quit and return back to the metadata cleanup prompt. To remove the domain controller from Active Directory, run the command remove selected server. Windows will prompt you asking if you want to proceed. Once I select yes, the command controller DC3 will be removed from Active Directory. There is one last record that needs to be removed to complete the process. To remove this record, run Active Directory Sites and Services. I will cover the Sites and Services tool in a lot more detail in a later video, so don't worry if you don't understand it yet. To complete the removal of the domain controller, expand down until you see the server. Notice that DC1 and DC2 are still listed as being in the domain as domain controllers. DC3 is not listed as being part of the domain, so the metadata cleanup has worked. To complete the process, simply press delete and delete the record. This covers how to seize an operational master role and how to remove the Active Directory configuration for that domain controller after the operational master role has been seized. But what happens if after you seize the role, you manage to recover the server? The important thing to remember is to not put the server back on the network. If you start the domain controller back up, you will essentially have two domain controllers on the network with the same operational master role. This can potentially cause all kinds of problems. The best option is to reformat and start again, but you may have data on the server that you want or software that is difficult or time-consuming to reinstall. To recover the server, first pull out the network cable from the server. This will stop it from communicating to clients and other domain controllers and potentially causing problems. Next, start the server up with the network cable not plugged in and remove Active Directory from the server. Once Active Directory is removed, you can reinstall Active Directory using DC Promo. Let's have a look at how to remove Active Directory from a server. To remove Active Directory from a server, you can demote the server using DC Promo. If I were to run DC Promo on this server, it would fail. DC Promo would attempt to contact another domain controller, which is not possible since I unplugged the network. To remove Active Directory with the network cable unplugged, run the command DC Promo with the switch force removal. This will force Active Directory to be removed from the server even if other domain controllers cannot be contacted. I will get a warning message telling me that an operational master role is held by this server and should be transferred before removing Active Directory. Since I seized the role already, I can safely ignore this message and move on. Next, I will get a message reminding me that this domain controller is also a global catalog server. Removing the last global catalog server would be a problem, but one of my other domain controllers is a global catalog server, so I can ignore this. Once I next my way past the welcome and information screen, I will be asked to choose a local administrator password. Once complete, this server will be put back into a work group, and thus you will need an administrator username and password to access the server. Now all I need to do is finish the wizard, and Active Directory will now be removed from the server. Once complete and the server has been rebooted, the server will be put into a work group. If you want the server to be part of Active Directory, you can add it to the domain and even run DC Promo again to make it a domain controller. That's it for seizing operational master roles. You can see that there are a lot of steps to seizing an operational master role and risks involved, so always try to transfer the role first where possible. In the next video, I will look at configuring an external time source. Configuring an external time source will allow you to ensure that your domain controllers and clients' times are correct. A lot of modern security requires the time on the computer being set correctly. Thanks for watching yet another free video from IT Free Training. Remember, the rest of this course and others are available to you on our YouTube channel and website.